Hello, we're going to take a moment to learn how to identify a mineral when you're sitting at home for an online lab and aren't quite sure what to do, using a flow chart that we're going to look at and then also a sheet of paper to record the results on. So we're going to look at this mineral here and use it as our example. It's important to note that other lab manuals might have different flow charts, and the one that I'm using is actually quite simplified, but they'll all work pretty much the same way.
The mineral identification chart acts like a flowchart, directing us to the correct name for a given unknown. First, we look to see if the mineral is metallic or not. This particular mineral does not look like metal, so it is non-metallic. Then we determine if it is harder or softer than glass by performing a scratch test. When we try to scratch the glass with this mineral, it won't scratch the glass. You may see a little white powder left behind, but that line will rub off. No true scratch was left behind. So this is softer or equal to glass, or softer or equal to 5.5. Since it is a soft mineral, it is nice to see if it is softer than my fingernail, which has a hardness of 2.5. As I try to scratch this mineral with my fingernail, it does not scratch it, so it must be harder than or equal to my nail. These two hardness tests puts this mineral somewhere from a 2.5 to 5.5 on the hardness scale. I posted a whole video on cleavage, so view that for more detailed help. This sample is straightforward. It has three planes of cleavage, one set on the front and back, one on the sides, and one on top and bottom. Remember, the matching pair is implied and does not have to be there. If the bottom of the sample was broken in a way that we could not see the cleavage plane, we know it is there because there is one on the top. They are just planes of weakness, so there is a large number in a given orientation. We should also note the cleavage planes are at 90 degrees to one another. For streak, since this mineral is white, we don't need to test it as it will just powder white. We have enough information now to identify our sample. Looking at this mineral identification chart, we find the non-metallic minerals that are softer than glass and that have cleavage. The bottom four can be light in color. Only two have three planes of cleavage. Calcite has rhombohedral cleavage, which means the planes are not at 90 degree angles to one another. Halite has cubic cleavage, which means the planes are at 90 degrees to one another. Since our sample's cleavage planes are at 90 degrees to one another, it looks like we have halite. Looking at the hardness of 2.5 for halite, this still makes sense. And of course, we could taste this to see if it tastes like salt.